All right, welcome to another beautiful day out here on the ranch. And today we are going to be putting in some barbed wire. Last video, I think we finished up a whole bunch of T-posts and fence line for about 1,000 feet of fence. And now it's time to get the wire up on that fence. So to do that, we could try to just drag the rolls of wire out there and just try to wheel them along the ground and such, but that's kind of annoying. So I have got this set up on the back of the tractor. This is a 3-point trailer hitch attachment that you can get for pretty much any tractor out there. They make them for pretty much anything that's category 1. I think they even make them for category 0s too. This is actually a category 2, but again, they fit just fine, they work. So it's a trailer hitch adapter with this guy, which is a wire unroller that goes on any trailer hitch. Now I could have actually put this on my vehicle. My vehicle is a 4Runner and I've got a trailer hitch on the back, so I could have put it on there instead of the tractor. But what I didn't like about that is, honestly, you're reeling out barbed wire. You can have barbed wire all over the place moving around, and I really didn't want it scratching up the vehicle. So out here, it's way out, back of the tractor, plenty away from things, should be just fine. So our first task is to get a roll up on here. We'll get the roll up on here, we'll get it out there, and we'll see how well we can get it unrolled. And then we'll take a look at getting it tensioned and getting clips on it and all the fun that is. And I'm going to make you watch me put up every single clip on that barbed wire, because that is not in any way the most monotonous and boring task in the history of mankind. So here we go. Alright, so we're gonna get this end wired up. To do that, we've just bent it around. We'll bring it over close as we can to a 90 degree angle to the wire coming in, and go under. And we'll just keep doing that over and over and over and over and over again. And how many times do I do it? Kind of until I get tired of doing it. It often ends up being, you know, 6, 7, 8 times or so. Usually pretty much just until I get tired of it. Now, others may have better ways of doing this, absolutely. Plenty of videos on YouTube of putting barbed wire together. It just happens to be how I do it. Been holding fine so far. As you can see, I've got two other wires already in here that are holding up quite well, nice and tight on those. So that's this end. Now we'll take the tractor, we'll go to the other end, reel out the wire on the way, and we'll get it tensioned at the other end. So when I'm rolling out wire, I drive along pretty slow in the tractor, and the reason for that is I'm looking out the back and I'm looking for the wire to get taut, because I have had this thing with the tractor be strong enough to snap a wire completely if it gets bound up. And since I'd rather not repair a wire, I just look for it getting taut, and then I stop and go out and fix it, and then keep going if I have to. So at the moment, it's going pretty well. We're gonna drive like this to the other end, nice and slowly. And remember that whole the wire getting taut and bound up thing I was talking about? Yeah, there it is. That's exactly what I mean. Now, had I kept going, it would have snapped the wire, because there's enough strength in that mount, and certainly in the tractor and the pipe at the other end, to do it. So thankfully, we caught it. We'll go out and fix it. We'll head to the other end and we'll get it wired up. But this is one of the things you gotta look for with any of this stuff, that you don't actually just break the wire going down. So yeah, lots of fun.
Well, we made it to the other end. Let's see, it only bound up 2 more times on the way down, so not too bad. You should see how much it binds up. So this roll is actually on a reel here. And if that reel gets destroyed, which I destroyed one testing this out previously, using just a piece of 3/4 inch pipe as my unroller. That didn't work quite so well because it actually broke the pipe from the tension on it. But in doing so, it actually destroyed the reel. So when you're rolling this out without a reel, it really does not turn very well, and you have to stop every little while to get it unbound up. However, with the reel on, much better. Doesn't bind up nearly as much, so definitely keep the reel on if possible. So let's talk a little bit about the tools that we're going to use here. So first of all, we have this guy. This is just a piece of, what is this, inch and a half PVC pipe with some fittings on top to make it fit over the top of either one of these nice posts or a T-post. And the reason I did that is because if it fits over the top of it like that, it holds itself up. And the reason I want it to hold itself up, these lines on here are measured for where I want the barbed wire to be. And so it's a lot easier to line things up when this thing holds itself in place and you're not just, you know, trying to put it in place and hold this in place and it's just a giant mess. So this, we're gonna stick over here out of the way on that side, but that tells us where we want our barbed wire to be. This guy is how we're gonna tension our barbed wire. And there's a couple different models of this. This is called a goldenrod. There's a couple different models of this. This particular model I like because it has two clamps at this end. So you put this end around the post over here, and you put the wire through here. And then as you jack this up, right, it tensions the wire, and that's great. But for a long section of wire like this, I could pull 3 or 4 feet potentially through this in order to put enough tension on it, because, you know, it's quite a long section. It's, you know, snaking along on the ground. So I got a lot that I got to pull out of it. And what's nice about having two clamps here is you can pull this over. And then when you're done, when this gets all the way up, you clamp this one and then bring that one back. And then clamp this one and do it again. And you can do that as much as you need to in order to get the right tension on that wire. So that's the next thing to do. We'll get this set up and I'll show you how it gets used. All right, so to get us started here, we're gonna take our goldenrod. We'll put it about where it's supposed to be, maybe a little bit below it. And now we try to hook up our wire. And you got to hold kind of a couple things in place to make this work, but there's our first clamp on our wire. And then with that first clamp in place, we're just going to start ratcheting, start pulling. And you can see it's pretty loose to start with, but it gets tight quick. But what you can see is, right, I'm at the end, essentially, of the length of this goldenrod, and I need more. So that's what the second clamp over here is. We'll put that clamp in, then we can let the first one go, and now it's held by the second. Let the first clamp go, push this back down, clamp that back in again, and start pulling again. And we just do that as much as we need to in order to get it tight. Now, different people have different definitions of tight. And we know that barbed wire does not need to be banjo tight, right? These other wires, they're tight, but you can still move them around. And my rule, and we'll see how well this works out in the end, my rule for how tight the wire should be is on this goldenrod, I should be able to pull on it as hard as I can here with one hand. I shouldn't be doing this and putting all my weight on it and stuff like that. Just one hand, make it as tight as I can with one hand, and I'm gonna call that tight enough. Now, as you can see, it looks like, I think I'm gonna have to probably do it again here. So we'll do another cycle here. Undo that clamp, push it back, put that clamp back on, and yep, just a little bit more. That should do it. Again, maybe a little more. Yeah, that's it. All right, so we've got our wire as tight as we need it. Next thing to do is going to be to, of course, wind it around this pipe here. One thing I should mention for everybody, these gloves that I'm wearing are wonderful. These are actually, if you're looking for the brand, they're Wells Lamont Farm and Ranch gloves. They're great. I can grab barbed wire like this. It does not puncture. Right on the barb, no problem. So these gloves are just a necessity for doing anything with barbed wire, in my opinion. Let's see. So, yep, that's it. All right. So let's get it clipped. Now I want to leave enough to go around the post and have plenty to come through and wind around the wire itself. So we're going to leave plenty on it. You'll notice that this whole time I've left it connected to the reel on the back of the tractor. And that just makes my life easy because it kind of holds one end for me. So we'll pull out our fencing pliers, get this thing cut. All right, so we've got our cut piece. Like I said, we're just gonna wind that around the end. We're gonna kind of look at our pipe over here. Yeah, it's not gonna move, that's plenty tight. So we're gonna look at our pipe over here. We'll try to put it roughly where the line is on our measuring pipe. And what I like to do on this end is actually go under for the first one. And so then come over the top. And once again, just keep wrapping it around until I get tired of wrapping it around. And again, 6-8 times or so. That should do it. All right, so that's it. Next thing to do is get the goldenrod off it. So to do that, we just push our handle the other way. You can hear it snap, and the goldenrod is free. All right, so that gets our wire on. Now, we gotta walk that line, and we gotta put some clips on. Ready to put our clip on. We keep these with us. I don't use them most of the time, but fencing pliers always good to have for the clips that don't cooperate. What I like to use is this guy. It's a clip bender. You can find these on Amazon, any number of other places, but I like it. It makes this pretty quick to do. We just take the wire, bring it up to about where the measurement needs to be. So in our case, right about there. Put this around, and as you'll notice, I got a barb right in the way, but it doesn't matter. We'll stick the clip bender through, bend it around. On the other side, grab that end and just bend it, and we're done. And that's it. Now I got to do that about, 50 more times down this line. So hooray for that. I'm going to make you watch it. No, I'm not. We're going to actually take a little break, and we'll come back when I'm done, and we'll talk about how things went. Well, there it is. Finally, 1,000 feet of fence complete. So this is great. This means that we can officially say that we have 1/8 of the fence project done, which I know doesn't maybe seem like much, but it's actually a pretty great piece of progress to make for basically 2 weekends. So I'm pretty happy about that, actually. So the next thing we're going to be doing out here is going and putting up gates. We got a gate to put up right here. I got another one to put down at the other end of this. So we'll get those gates in. That'll be the next video. We also got to come out here, and I think my wife wants to do some planting. So we'll see about getting some random stuff in the ground and hopefully getting some temporary watering set up for it and things like that. So stay tuned. We got a lot more to do. We'll see you soon.